My name is George Lovett. I'm from Baltimore, Maryland, and I decided to audition for American Idol because I had auditioned in the past before, and I feel like I got sent home a little bit too early, and I'm just back to kind of redeem myself. My three friends and I, we decided to, you know, audition as a quartet. We did like Georgia On My Mind, just, you know, to welcome the judges to Georgia. I let them know that this time I was back and I wanted to win the competition. And they told me, you have the voice to win, but you know, you just need to work on a little more expression. And you know, they said, I have the voice for it, but I just need to do a little bit more. So I'm going to take that and I'm going to work on it. And this time we have before we go to Hollywood, I'm going to perfect it and just make it great. I got my golden ticket. And I don't know, I think I was the only one who was kind of, you know, into myself a little bit. I felt like I was in a cloud. I was just spacing out a little bit. I felt like it just wasn't real, like it was a dream, because I've thought of this moment for so long. It's been about a year that I've been planning on coming back to American Idol and just hopefully taking it to the top. So since I got that golden ticket, it's just confirmation that I can do it. I have a lot of musical influences. One person who really influences me is the singer Brandy. Just because of her recording, she's like a very skillful recording artist. Also, I grew up in a family with a lot of women, a lot of belting high sopranos. So Patti LaBelle, she's been a big influence on me and, you know, my performance also. I think what makes me unique is I bring an urban type of, you know, rhythm and blues, soulful pop type of thing to the competition. I don't think anybody's of, maybe Candace, she brought that soulful quality to it, but I wanna really push it and bring it, like Frank Ocean, kind of cool, you know, up to date type of thing. I'm the next American Idol because I feel like I have a voice. I feel like God placed a voice in me, and I feel like it's just my duty to present it to the world. I feel like I would be just betraying everything I believe in not to, you know, be the next American Idol, or at least try, you know.